Hi, hello, welcome to Maths Guru channel. In this video, I am going to explain exercise 4.3. First question, given that it is L is parallel to M, to prove angle 1 is supplemented to angle 8, write reasons for the statement. Here statement and reasons given. Here this is a given figure. These two L and M are parallel lines and this line is a transversal. Whenever the line transversal line intersect two parallel lines at two distinct points, then it will form 8 angles. Okay, now see, L is parallel to M. If L is parallel to M, then angle 1 plus angle 8 is equals to 180 degrees. Why? Because these angle 1 and angle 8 are exterior angles on the same side of the transversal. For this is a transversal, angle 1 and angle 8 same side, one side only it lies. So these we can call angles are same side on the transversal, exterior angles also. Why we are calling these are exterior, further I will explain. I will draw that figure and I'll explain clearly. Once according to these reasons, once listen here. Angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 1 and angle 5 both are equal. Why? Because these are corresponding angles. Next, angle 5 plus angle 8, 180 degrees. Angle 5 plus angle 8, 180 degrees. Why? Because these are the linear pair angles. Okay. So, the angles which are adjacent and some should be 180, then we should call those are linear pair angles. So, these two are linear pair angles. Angle 1 plus angle 8 is 180 degrees. Exterior angles on the same side of the transversal. Reason, okay, angle 1 is supplemented to angle 8. Exterior angles on the same side of the transversal, so angle 1 is equal to angle 8 also, we can say that. Okay, see, this I said no, I will explain. I will draw the figure and I'll explain clearly what are exterior, what are interior. Suppose if any two lines are parallel, if a line which intersect two parallel lines at two distinct points. A line which intersects two lines at two distinct points, that is called a transversal. This is called a transversal. Okay. Now, whenever this transversal intersect at two distinct points of the parallel lines, L and M are parallel lines, then four angles will form here. You can write your wish. Four angles, 1, 2, 3 are ABC. Here I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Here 5, 6, 7, 8. Anyway, we can take, no problem. Here, these two, angle 1 and angle 3 are vertically opposite angles. 4 and 2 are vertically opposite angles, those are equal. And angle 8, angle 6 are vertically opposite. 5 and 7 are vertically opposite angles. Okay, now you can write vertically opposite angles. Angle 4, angle 2, angle 1, angle 3, angle 5, angle 7, angle 6, angle 8. Pair of vertically opposite angles. Next, see here. Angle 8 and angle 7, angle 4 and angle 1. These are exterior angles. Why we are calling exterior angles? Why? Because these four angles are lies outside, exterior of the parallel lines, outside of the parallel lines. These two are parallel lines. These angles lie where that lies outside of the parallel lines. So we can call exterior angles. Now see, angle 3, angle 2, angle 5, angle 6. These four angles are interior angles. Why we are calling interior angles? Why? Because these four angles are lies inside of the parallel lines. Inside of the parallel lines. Next, coming to the corresponding angles. So these are angle 7, angle 1, angle 8, angle 4 are corresponding angles. And those are exterior angles. Okay, now, and that lies one side of the transversal. Angle 7, angle 1 is one side of the transversal, and angle 8, angle 4 also either side of the transversal. Now, 4 and 6, 2 and 5, and 3 and 6, 2 and 5. These are interior alternating interior angles. Interior, inside of the parallel lines. So, alternate either side of the transversal. This is a transversal. These angles lies either side of the transversal. Either side it means one angle is this side, one angle is this side for the transversal. So, we can call either side of the transversal. Okay, interior and either side of the transversal means we can call interior angles. We can call alternating interior angles. Alternating interior angles. Next, alternating exterior angles. 4, 7, 1, 8. 4, 7 and 1, 8 are the alternating exterior angles. Why? Because those are either side of the transversal and outside of the parallel lines. So, we can call exterior, alternating exterior angles. This is about the 4 plus 4, 8 angles and how they form and what we can call, which type of angles, those are all I explained. Okay, coming to the next second question. Here one figure given. That figure ratio is given y is to 5 is equal to 3 is to 7. Find x value. See how we can find x value. Let us see here. These are parallel lines. One is a transversal is given. Now AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF. Now you can take the names of parallel lines. AB, CD, EF. These are the parallel lines. Now from figure x plus y is equal to 180 degrees. Why? Because these are interior angles. Interior angles on the same side of the transversal. See, these two are parallel lines. This is a transversal. These two angles are lies one side of the transversal. Yes or no? And interior also. Inside of the two lines are there. No, interior angles. Interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Also y plus z is equal to 180 degrees. Equation 1 and equation 2. Once see here. RHS are equal. So we should equate LHS. X plus y is equal to y plus z. Okay, we can take. See, x plus y is equal to y plus z we can take. And y will get cancelled. X is equal to z, that is equal to 126. How you can get 126? Let us see. Sum of the ratio I took, 7 plus 3, 10. Now y is equals to 3. Corresponding ratio is 3. 3 by total ratio, 10 into 180 degrees. Now 0 cancel, 3 into 18. 3 18 is 54. Z is equal to z ratio is 7. 7 by 10 into 180 degrees. 10, what is 10? Total ratio. Okay. Now 0 cancel, 7 18 is 126. Now y is equal to 54, z is equal to 126. Now x is equal to z, I said no. So x is equal to z is equal to 126. Okay. This value is 126. That only we need to find out what is x value. Okay. I hope you understood. Thank you.